Well, this place is ready. We'll be right back to get this series started in just a minute. Welcome in, everybody. Glad you're with us. The show presents the National League Division Series. It's the New York Mets taking on the Philadelphia Phillies. Hi, folks. John Ciambi alongside Chris Singleton. Game one is always critical in a postseason series, Singy.
Yeah, and this is when you love having home field advantage, Boog. If you capture game one, you're full of confidence that you've got a chance to ride that momentum for the rest of the series.
And on the visiting side, starting pitching is always the big key in a game like this to kick off a series.
Yeah, you need a strong performance on the mound. That's the number one way to cancel out the home field edge we just mentioned.
First pitch coming your way next. Just about set to go. And today's starter, Ranger Suarez. Chris, what should we keep an eye on here with him?
Well, he comes at hitters with a five-pitch mix, so for him, it's always interesting to see how he utilizes those weapons. He may lean on one or two pitches depending on how things are going and how things are working, but if he can control four or even five of those offerings, look out, hitters. It's going to be a tough day. He's really going to be able to keep those guys off balance.
Swings through that.
One ball, two strikes.
Pitches in the dirt. The count now 2-2. And he deals. That misses the zone. 3-2 now.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. And a swing and a miss. And one out now.
He had him out in front, which isn't easy to do against a hitter like this, known for using the entire field. Just couldn't sit back long enough on that one.
Here's Brandon Nimmo. One down, base is empty. And it's fouled away. Here's a 2-2. And another ball. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. Two quick outs at the top of the first here tonight.
Oh, nothing too fancy on the strikeout pitch right there. Just a low 90s fastball, and I'm not sure he was trying to challenge him, but that's pretty much what happened. Very hittable location, but he found a way to just get it by him.
Back to the mound. He's got it. Tosses to first. And it's a 1-2-3 inning. Mets go down quickly. And now it's the Phillies' turn. No score. This is the National League Division Series on the show. And we're back. And towing the slab here, Paul Blackburn.
He really relies on working down in the zone with that heavy sinker he's got. You know, it's not as popular to throw that pitch today as it used to be because, you know, guys are looking to hit balls down in the zone, get them up in the air. It's very important for him when facing same side hitters to be able to get it in, especially early in the count, and to opposite guys be able to throw it at that front hip and run it over the inside corner.
Left-hand hitter waits. Swing and a miss for the strikeout. Chase the fastball up the ladder for strike three.
Well, that high four-seam fastball has become such a great pitch for pitchers to finish hitters off. They're trying to stay back with two strikes, make sure that they can handle something off speed, and just with good spin rate, good rotation through the zone, elevated a little bit, get a lot of swings and misses, and that's a really nice job right there.
Trey Turner at the plate. 3-1, and he couldn't come up with it.
Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted in first base with a quick free pass.
Runner on at first with one gone. And now here is Harper. Turner runs. There's a ball. Safe at second, and that was not close.
Well, a nice lead and a nice steal there to get into scoring position with the heart of the order at the plate. That might just lead them to pitching around these hitters a little more because of the open base, but it's early in this ball game. Can't imagine it'll change the attack plan too much.
There's a swing and a drive. Nimmo going back on it. Pulls it in on the warning track. Runner tags at second. And time now for the Phillies lineup. And the key to victory for them here, get their starter some run support early.
Boog, if they can get him that run support early, it's likely the other team folds because they know how dominant he can be once he gets settled in. So put pressure on that other team right away. Jump out to a lead early, and a few runs is going to feel like 30.
Nick Castellanos at the plate now. In the air, right field. He's got it, and that's the inning. Phillies strand one, scoreless after one. All set for the start of the inning. And stepping in for New York, Pete Alonso. The pitch. It's softly on the ground left side. Boom. Goes out to first. And that takes care of Alonso. Jeff McNeil stands in. In the postseason, you see just how important every last play can be. You never know what's going to make the difference in the end. And a swing and a miss.
Like you said, Boog, every play is so pivotal at this point of the year. As a player, you've got to be locked in. Can't make a mistake that could cost your team the season.
And the 1-2 misses to even the count. The punch out there. He battled for a long time, but it finishes with a strikeout. You can't be mad at yourself after an at-bat like that one. J.D. Martinez stands in. Oh, he doesn't get the call. And that's ball two. And a pitch. And JD gets a piece. Now 2-2. Two down, nobody on. And that's outside. Counts full, 3-2. No score here in the second. In the air, right side. And that is that. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Back at Citizens Bank Park. Bottom of the inning. And now it's Alec Bohm. And here it comes. And a foul ball. Slice to right, and it stays fair. And that rolls into the corner. Around first, heading for two. And the bottom of the second starts with a double.
Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there. Runner in scoring position now and a good opportunity to push across the first run of the ball game.
This is Bryson Stott. The pitch. Tapped at the plate, but it's a foul ball. On the ground, right side, and that's just foul. Runner in scoring position, nobody out here in game one of the NLDS. One and two now. Swing and a ball hit out towards left center field. Hauls it in for the out.
That's a really nice play ranging back into the outfield for that catch. We all know those can be a little tricky, especially if the wind's swirling around out there.
And up to the plate is JT Realmuto.
Jacob Tyler Realmuto, he has quite the trophy case as a multiple-time All-Star, Silver Slugger, and Gold Glove winner. This guy's a great leader by example for his team.
The Phillies looking to strike first here in game one. Swings and misses. One and two.
Good pitch right there. Tied him up on the hands. If I'm out there on the bump, I'm going right back in there.
Foul ball still, one and two count. Man at second. Pitch misses there. Yeah, that's ball two. And that's outside. Boom. The runner at second with one away. Bounce to the left side. Lindor. The throw to first. And Realmuto is out. Brandon Marsh steps to the plate. The Phils with a chance to score first. Bottom half of inning number two. Two outs. And down on strikes he goes. That's the third out. Inning over.
He's in a tough spot, had to make a great pitch, did it, got the strikeout, gets out of the jam. Clearly, he's happy with those results.
Well, here we go, top of the third, scoreless game. And stepping in for New York, Starling Marte. On the ground. And it's through for a hit. So a man on base to start the inning.
He kind of rolled over on this pitch a little bit, but he got enough behind it to shoot it through for a knock. And you'll take that anytime you can get him to find a hole.
Here's the second baseman. At the belt and fires.
That's ball two.
That one finds the corner. It's two and two.
I mean, that's perfect location, right on the black. I mean, over and over again, this guy demonstrates the ability to hit those spots. They're so tough to do anything with as a hitter.
Over to first, and he's saved. That one almost got him. And a 3-2. That one down the line, and it goes just foul. And a pitch. Hit in the air, center field. Settles under it. One down. Francisco Alvarez digs in now. Top of the third, no score. And another ball. And a swing and a miss. Two out.
Well, I'm not sure what he was waiting on right there. He got the changeup and still late on it. You rarely see that. It almost makes you think that he was trying to set the pitcher up. I mean, if you can't catch up to the off-speed stuff, there's no way you're going to touch a fastball.
Back to the top of the Mets order. Here's Francisco Lindor. Two outs. And there's a strike. The pitch. The shortstop takes the ball. Two gone, but the go-ahead run is at first. We're here in the top half of inning number three. Got him looking. That's a strikeout. Mets strand one, and we are still scoreless. And welcome back to the ballpark. And now here's a speed threat. Outfielder, Johan Rojas. Ball to strike. Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit. So now back to the top of the order.
Everything came together for him. Not much to this one other than just a willingness to go the other way and put the ball in play. That's a team at bat right there. Nice job of staying back and letting the ball get deep. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Back to the top of the lineup. Kyle Schwarber comes up to hit here. Righty delivers. And a pitch out, but no steal, and it's ball two. Rojas on at first, nobody out. Blackburn keeping an eye on him.
Base runner with a one-way lead right there. All he's trying to do is get a look at the pitcher's move. Had no intent of stealing on that pitch.
This one trailed right center field. That one heading for the fence and gone. A gigantic blast. It's 2-0. Listen to these fans.
This place is absolutely buzzing right now. You can feel the energy all the way up here in our broadcast booth. Knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spit on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
Here's Turner now. And a big swing and a miss.
Can be tough to bounce back after a big home run, but nobody on, nobody out. You just have to treat it as a fresh inning.
Nobody out with a pair of runs across in the frame here in the last half of the third. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout.
Very frustrating right there as a speedy potential base runner when with two strikes, you just struggle to put the ball in play. You don't even have to get a hit at that point. You can help your team just by reaching on an error, but some way you got to find a way to shorten up the swing and put the ball in play next time.
Here comes a pitch. Up the middle. Fires to first on the run. Awesome play there. Two outs, base is empty. Here's Nicholas Castellanos. Two outs, base is empty. And another ball. That one is inside ball four. And I mean, oh, so close.
It's been a little bit of a shaky inning, but he's still in a good spot to get out of this thing without giving up any more runs. He's just got to turn the page and go after this next guy.
Just off the inside edge.
Looks like he's being a little cautious with him in this at bat after doubling the first time up. Doesn't want to make another mistake.
Kicks and fires. Here's a rip to short, but he's there for the third out. But two come across to score in the inning, courtesy of this two-run homer. It's now a 2-0 ball game. You're watching the National League Division Series on the show. Back here in Philadelphia, John Ciampi with Chris Singleton, and set to lead off the fourth, Brandon Nimmo. The wind of the pitch. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
And now it's Mark Vientos. Up the middle, stop. Throws to first. Two up, two down. Two outs, base is empty. Now at the plate, Pete Alonso. And another ball.
Good spot there, but didn't get the strike at the knees and doesn't seem too convinced by the call out there on the mound as he tries to get a better sense of the umpire strike zone.
Right down on strikes. Picks up strikeout number seven. And the Mets go down 1-2-3. And they're down 2-0. Game one of the division series. Now it's the second baseman, Bryson Stott. The 1-1.
Love coming to Citizens Bank Park. Best ice cream in all of the league at the press level. It's only been around since 2004, but plenty of awesome history here already. It's the only stadium with multiple postseason no-hitters. Remember, Roy Halladay did it back in 2010, and the Houston Astros threw a combined no-no in Game 4 of the 2022 World Series.
Headed down the line. Nobody can get there, and it's a foul ball. And the right-hander deals. Swings, throw it, and that's a strikeout.
Well, that's a curveball that people like to describe as a hammer or Uncle Charlie, and you can see why. It's not a looping slow curve. He throws it hard, and it gets plenty of bite on the end.
And now it is JT Real Muto. Base is empty, one away. We're here in the bottom of the fourth. That misses the zone. Full countdown. Got him swinging. So digging in, Brandon Marsh. The pitch. And a foul ball. And a pitch. Goes down looking.
Impeccable command in that one. Three batters, three strikeouts. That's electric stuff out there on the mound.
Here, Citizens Bank Park, and now here's Jeff McNeil.
These fans have to feel good right about now. This series not going to be easy, but they have the lead at home in game one. That brings the anxiety down a few notches. Well, these Mets showing great discipline at the plate, and patience definitely seems to be the name of their game in this one. Starter's leash has to be getting tighter with his pitch count where it is, but so far he's been really effective in this one.
Puts and misses. It's a strikeout.
Really love the pitch sequence right there. I'm telling you what, pitcher and catcher on the same page right now.
Here's J.D. Martinez. One down, base is empty.
You know, sometimes it just takes getting to the bullpen in order to be able to score runs, and that might be the case today.
And a pitch. Way out front for strike two. One out, base is empty. Swings and misses, struck him out. Here's Starling Marte. Two down, nobody on. And downstairs.
Now this offense has just been locked down. Almost five full innings of shutout baseball.
Right side. Stop. Fires over to first. Marte retired. And the Mets go 1-2-3. Nothing doing for the Mets. They trail things here 2-0. We head to the bottom of the fifth. And now the center fielder, Johan Rojas. Right through there for a strike. Action in the pen down there. David Peterson, the southpaw, is throwing and getting that sinker dialed in. Quintana getting cranked up as well. Here's a 1-2. Fights it off, he'll see another. And a ball and two strikes. Fouls it back with two strikes. The pitch. This one in the air, center field. makes the catch, and there's one away. So the lineup flips over, and digging in for Philadelphia, Kyle Schwarber. The 1-1. Foul ball. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. Now two away. Two outs, bases empty. Trey Turner now. This guy makes great contact. One of the best in the game at putting bat on ball.
He's got such quick hands, and he's gaining pitch recognition. That keeps him square to the plate. There's a good chance that his bat stays in the zone a long time, and that produces solid contact consistently.
Bounce to third, and foul ball. Two down, nobody on. Last half of inning number five. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. And he deals. Fouled off the plate. They'll do it again.
Well, just about to hit that century mark. 100 pitches for this game.
Here's the 2-2. And another ball.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with the three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk. That's a great at bat. He saw a lot of pitches and earned a walk.
It feels to me like his time on the mound is running short, starting to show some signs of fatigue. So let's see how much longer they let him go.
Two outs. Backed off the plate that time. Here's Harper, the count 2-1. On the ground to third. This looks like extra bases. Around second is Turner, coming home. He'll score easily, and they're up by three.
Left-hander on now, David Peterson.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their players a chance to fight back into the game.
Stepping in, Nick Castellanos. The pitch. Ground ball, left side. Vientos sends it across to first. That ends the inning and stops things from getting out of hand. Phillies with the run scoring double. It's now 3-0. All set for the top of the sixth. Here's the second baseman, number 11. Up the middle, on the run, throw to first. Leadoff man retired in the sixth.
I love how guys at this level are able to slow the game down, whether it's in the batter's box or on defense. And right there, that was a good job of knowing just how much time he had. We talk about that internal clock. He was able to gather himself, get a good grip, and make an accurate throw across the diamond.
Francisco Alvarez up now for the Mets. A wind and a pitch.
Two balls, two strikes.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Pulled the string on the changeup.
Bogey just ran out of patience there. He took a couple of pitches to even that count up at 2 balls and 2 strikes, but that time chased outside the zone.
So the batting order turns over. Francisco Lindor up now for the Mets. Two down, nobody on. Swing and a ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit.
Only 2 hits allowed so far tonight, Boog, so I don't think that one will disrupt his momentum all that much. You know, he's really been on top of his game, commanding his pitches all night long.
Brandon Nimmo up now for the Mets. Hammer, base hit. Throw in holds the lead runner at second. Two on now with two away. Mark Vientos will hit next. Two on, two outs. So now 1-2. Two outs. And a swing and a miss. And that's the third out. So another good inning for him on the mound. 6 shutout innings now. It's the Phillies 3 and the Mets nothing. Back at Citizens Bank Park. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Here's the third baseman, Alec Bohm. The line of the pitch. That one misses. 2-1. Double-barreled action in the bullpen. Number 72 appears to be getting ready. And I'm sure he's feeling some nerves. This would be his major league debut. Garrett also getting ready. The wind to kick the pitch. Right through there for a strike.
Well, he had a pretty good look at that pitch and not sure exactly what tied him up there. Couldn't pull the trigger. And perhaps the best pitch you'll see in this at-bat to hit.
And now the lefty. A little bit low. Ripped on the ground a second. Toss to Alonso. One up, one down. And now Bryson Stott. Base is empty, one away here in the bottom of the sixth. And another ball. Outside, and that is ball four.
You get a walk, and you get a walk. Everyone gets a walk, Boog.
JT Realmuto steps in.
JT Realmuto, straight out of Carl Albert High School in Midwest City, Oklahoma.
Runner, runner on the go. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Man at first, one away. The 1-2 stays alive. The pitch. Double play ball to second. And that one handled. Slings to second. Throw to first, but he beat it. Man at first. Brandon March now at the plate. Realmuto off of first with two away. Next offering is in for a strike. Left-hand batter waits. Good job to fight that one off. Step off throw to first. Realmuto gets back easily. Realmuto runs. Pitch misses. Throw to second. He's safe.
Well, he picked over once just before the pitch to check on him, but that didn't seem to slow up his jump on the pitch at all. I think that guy's been studying some video. Awesome job to be prepared. Got the timing down, and he gets into scoring position.
Runner at second, two down. Well struck, right field. That's back there. Onto the warning track, and he hauls it in. One left for Philadelphia, but they lead it 3-0. And we're back. Top of inning number 7. And here's the first baseman, Pete Alonso. The Mets in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. I need a good at bat out of him right here.
Swing and a miss. He was late. Strike 2. Some stirring in the bullpen for the Phillies. Carlos Estevez appears to be getting loose. Strom also throwing. Swing and a miss. Struck him out.
That was a pretty good pitch. Top of the strike zone. We're seeing more fastballs in that location. Hitters, especially with two strikes, have to be ready to pull the trigger.
Jeff McNeil up now for the Mets. And a pitch. He swings and fouls one off. The Phillies leading by 3 here in the late stages of game 1. Kicks and deals. Lifted in the air down the left side. Turner in pursuit. Hauls it in for the out.
Well, that's a tough play for the infielder, ranging back into the outfield. There's part of him that's saying, hey, where are you at, outfielder? Call me off. But he stayed focused and made a nice catch right there.
And here is J.D. Martinez. And a pitch. And another ball. Now a bullet to second base, but he's got it to end the inning. Down in order go the Mets. They trail it here 3-0. Bottom of the 7th, and now for the Phillies, Johan Rojas. That one catches the zone, and that is strike 2.
Dangerous spot for that slider right there. Didn't seem to quite finish out front and get that sharp break. Tell you what, he doesn't want to throw that pitch again.
And that's outside, and the count's even at 2. And here it comes. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. Two-two. Just missed. Foul ball, and it remains a full count. Kicks and fires. Foul. We'll see another payoff pitch. The lefty fires. Chases the fastball up the ladder, struck him out. So now here's the DH, Kyle Schwarber. His two-run homer back in the third was an important swing of the bat in this one.
Yeah, there's no doubt he helped set the tone fairly early and certainly part of the reason why they've got the lead right now.
One down, base is empty.
Nope, outside.
And another ball.
Three ball, one strike.
On the ground to the left. Throws to first in time. Score at 5-3 for the second out with the third baseman shifted over there. Two outs, base is empty. Here's Trey Turner. Two down, nobody on. Swings through that one for strike two.
This guy's sink has so much drop in it, it's almost like a split finger fastball. Instead of just weak contact and balls on the ground, he gets swings and misses.
Two down, nobody on. Here the bottom of the seventh. That one the other way. Base hit.
Kind of a risky pitch coming inside with the breaking ball like that. You have to bury it. Otherwise, it's not too difficult to get the bat to it like he did that time.
So, man aboard. Here's Harper now. Here comes a pitch. Just missed. Two outs. Turner runs. Bounced up the middle. Whips it to first. Out with room to spare, and that's the inning. Phillies strand one, but they're on top by a count of 3-0. We go to the eighth. Starling Marte up to hit.
Oh, you can't ask for a better start to this series if you're the home team. You've got the lead, your starter's still on the mound, and there's a chance she finishes this thing.
Swing and a miss. Nice changeup. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. Now it's the second baseman. And that drops in for a strike. That one almost got him.
Straightened him up a little bit.
Two balls, two strikes.
Base is empty, one away, and we're in the top of the eighth. And a pitch. On the ground to third. Boom. Slings it across. Two up, two down here at the top of the eighth. Manager out of the dugout now, and it looks like we'll see a change on the mound. Ranger Suarez won't go any further, and we'll be back with their first arm out of the pen after a quick break. Here's the new pitcher for the Phillies, Jeff Hoffman. He has a great slider with tons of movement. Two outs, base is empty. And next for the Mets, Francisco Alvarez. Two down, nobody on. Right through there for a strike.
Well, in this one, the offense has sputtered. Somebody's got to find a way to get on, keep the line moving, and manufacture at least one run. Then maybe you get two or three.
Dives, but it kicks off his glove. Still able to get it there in time. And they get it out on the play. Mets go down quickly. They trail in this one 3-0. On to the bottom of the eighth. And now the right fielder, Nick Castellanos. And he pumps it a strike. And that one is lifted in the air. Lindor under it. Hauls it in, and there's one away. Alec Bohm stands in for the Phillies. The pitch. Late with the swing there.
One ball, two strikes.
This one in the air. Makes the catch for the out. Here's the second baseman, Bryson Stott. Two outs. Off the mark there. And a count 2-1. He goes down looking. Down quickly go the Phillies, but they lead it 3-0. Back here in Philadelphia, new inning getting started. Francisco Lindor comes up to the plate. Right-handed reliever. And a foul ball, third base side.
They hope he's the guy to spark a comeback. He tends to play better when his team is behind, so why not him?
Righty to the plate. To third. Boom. Jump throw. And they get the out. Brandon Nimmo up now for the Mets. And a foul ball. He stays alive. One down. Base is empty. Fights that one away. Still 1-2. Righty delivers. Swings and misses, two away.
Well, you see him trying to pull that inside pitch right there, and that's not the kind of approach that you want to have. Even if you do get to it, it's going to be very difficult to keep it fair. You're just going to make it a long strike at best. You have to be able to stay within the baseball on the inside of that path to it, and that way, if you're a little quick, the ball gets hit hard somewhere, and it's not foul.
Swing and a miss, chased it out of the zone. Hoffman is just one strike away. And that one missing low. Here's a swing and a drive left field, and he knew it. A massive home run. It's 3-1. That one just sounded different.
And might have been.
in the loudest moment yet. Man, my ears are ringing. I can feel that swing from the booth.
Sometimes we say it's a sinker that didn't sink. Well, that was a splitter that just didn't split. Kind of like a BP fastball, though. When you throw that pitch, don't expect to get it back. You're getting a new baseball from the umpire.
Carlos Estevez will take over here.
These are the spots relievers really make a name for themselves, late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time, there's a reason they're put in these situations.
So two away with nobody on. And next will be the cleanup hitter, Pete Alonso. Two outs. Hey.
It's pretty early in this series to say a must-win game, but when you've got home field advantage, it's a luxury, but you have to protect it. Huge win in game one to set the tone.
Not a ton of offense to chat about as we look at the final numbers, but this was a good one.
Yeah, it was a low-scoring game, Boog, but sometimes those can be the best, especially this time of year.
And your final, 3-1. The Phillies hang on to win it. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Ciampi saying so long.